So the lesson for this day, I'm going to talk about the planets. They are important ones from way back 3,000 years ago, when they're starting to make names for those ones that are there all the time in the sky, and the ones that they've been plotting and looking at. They didn't need those big telescopes, they just went straight with their eyesight in the many years of watching. The whole thing with astrology is like, you think of it like a big band around the planet. And the center of the solar system with astrology really is the Earth. So it goes through the Earth, and then all of the signs, the constellations. You know, there's the Libra up there, and there's the Scorpio over there. All of those constellations, they go around this planet, Earth, over their time frames. And so these are watched. And they're documented through all these years. And all the while this is going on, we have planets. And the planets are, I know this is terrible lighting, but the planets are, there are 7 planets that they see all the time. And they say, well, we're going to name them. And they were named after 7 gods originally. So these 7 gods. Planets were named after gods. So we can go through the names. It's very simple. Lundi is our moon, which is Monday. Tuesday, which is jeudi in French. I'm saying it's very easy now. I forgot who Judy went to. Mercredi. I'm too early on Judy. Judy is Jupiter for Thursday. So Judy is Jupiter. We have Friday, which is Vendredi, which is Venus. Originally was Venus. So the names of our week was originally named from these planets. We have Samedi and Dimanche. And there is Samedi, I believe, is Saturn, and Dimanche is the Sun. Okay, who did I miss in the middle? Mercredi is Mercury. And I'm still having a problem with Tuesday, what was it? Lundi, Mardi. Oh, Mardi. Mars. Okay. So Mars, the Mars planet is Tuesday. Okay. So now it's kind of making like a different important set all of a sudden. And astrology itself is like kicked up a notch, like a major notch, because now it has named the days of the week. Just by these gods out there, the known gods, our god planets. Now, so that's just something to wow about. So we have those major planets. We have the moon. We have Mars. We have Mercury. All of this is all in our vision, way back then. Just in the sky, Mercury, Jupiter, Venus, Saturn, and the Sun. So that's really the start of it. And then there we are, plotting it out. You know, plotting it out, like how long that one really stays around, or how quick that one goes. Everything, even way back then, the personality, behaviors, you know, a child is born, when that was going on, oh my gosh, a child is like this. I mean, it doesn't always match, exactly, and we can always attribute that to the chemicals in our systems that we intake through our lives. We can take chemicals or pesticides, those types of things. All of those things, you know, will take away from the exact match in your fortune of what you're like, you know, if from your natal charts. But in reality, that really should be your true self, what they've been saying all these years. It doesn't matter if there's one of you or 100 of you all born at that same minute. You're all going to have that same kind of setup with your personality set, your ego, all kinds of things, your attitude. You're going to have very similar. And the differences are going to be with your environmental and, of course, hereditary, what you've inherited. Because, if your parents just drank mercury drinks and out of lead pewter their whole lives, I imagine you're going to be a little bit different than others that were raised healthily. You know what I'm saying? So back to our sky, and there it is, and there it was plotted out. And that was, you know, back to the entertainment factor, that really was the entertainment. The TV, a child born at that time there, that time there is when the child was born, you know. Big reference to how that child is, you know, a big documentation has been going on and on and on. So it's not brand new, this last 100 years. It's not something they just made up. This is all pre-Bible. So when we're looking at, I can run you through briefly some of the planets themselves and their represent. The sun represents basic drive. You're just basic drive. That energy that you have, your go. The second, where are we next? We have, I won't go in order, I'm sorry. I don't have order. That's in my chart. We have Mercury. Now, Mercury is known for, my gosh, it's a lot of nervous energy in Mercury, anxiety energy. Is it the curiosity one? Oh gosh, I don't want to get you guys. Yeah, Mercury, I believe, is curiosity. Venus is attraction. Jupiter is luck, but also known to be in conjunction with philosophy. The philosophy of a person. We have Saturn. Now, Saturn is, that's the one I'm slow with. Saturn is duty. The representation of duty, how duty is for you, your duties in life, and blah blah blah. We have Uranus. Now, Uranus is contemplation. It's a contemplative. So if you're born in retrograde of Uranus, that means you're going to have difficulty in your life with contemplations. You're just not going to be a deep thinker so easy. It's going to be a lot of work for you. We have Neptune. Now, Neptune is a fun one. Neptune is fantasy. It's the fantasy in your mind. It's your imagination level, you know, how far you can go with it. Some people have incredible imaginations and others don't. And this is attributed to where Neptune was in your chart. Pluto. Oh my gosh, did I forget what Pluto is all about? Pluto, they keep throwing that word at me, catharsis. It's a catharsis planet, a planet of relief energy, of a healer in a way, like a cathartic No matter, you know, you just feel like you were bad in your energy today. Let's say you could have been a better person. It's a cathartic planet that that is a forgiving, and so there's I don't know if I got all of the planets. I maybe missed one, but that's where we're at. Yeah. So when they say like you have your Mars is in conjunction, Mars is in conjunction with Mercury. That means you have curious aggression. So that's something that you're maybe going to be odd with. That's going to be an odd thing, to be curiously aggressive. But I guess fact-finding and that type of thing, you know, maybe you're into getting into some kind of information aggressively, you know, your curiosity killed the cat type of syndrome. Yeah, so maybe that's just not a good thing to have all the time. But that's what it means, is when you put the two planets together, then you join them up. This is not mentioning the astrology symbols, like the Libra and the Scorpio. This is not listing them. They come in another band. They have another band, and they have other rites and rules also, you know. This, like Libra, is supposed to be dedicated to balance and, you know, those types of things. So when you have that going on with those other planets, so when those other planets are in their relationship, having their relationship moment, going in their transit and setting in, then you also have a constellation surprise that's joined in, and so you could have that happening at the same time. But really, this video was just about the days of the week, and that was just amazing to me, because I didn't know they were named after gods, and the gods thereby being those planets. So yeah, what an interesting people in the past, before they wrote the Bible. What an interesting people, and what a stuck people since. What a stuck bunch since that Bible has been written. What a castaway of that energy we've been getting. You know, the planet's been getting that energy from the very, very dawn of its time, and then just, you know, to recently cast it away because of this Bible's been written of good and evil. You know, just ridiculous. It's just ridiculous. Because in essence, the astrologies themselves, if you look at them, they're much deeper about the human relationships, what a person is, their personality sector, their relationship possibilities. It's a much deeper state of human that it develops in your mind. Whereas when you're just going good and evil, bad and evil, good and evil all the time, it's just really shallow place. Anyway, that's that.